Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in the previous video, we have seen that how to find the Laplace transform of the basic functions. So now, in this video and in the upcoming videos, we will see some of the useful properties of the Laplace transform which we will use during the circuit analysis. So in this particular video, we will see these four properties of the Laplace transform. And first, let us start with the linearity. And in fact, in the previous video, we have even used this property. So as per this property, if the Laplace transform of the function x1t is equal to x1s and the x2t is equal to x2s, then the Laplace transform of the x1t plus x2t is equal to the Laplace transform of the individual functions. That is L of x1t plus L of x2t, and that is equal to x1 of s plus x2 of s. So in general, we can say that the Laplace transform of this a times x1t plus b times x2t is equal to a times x1s plus b times x2s, where this a and b are the constants. So like I said in the previous video, we have even used this property. So if you recall, then while finding the Laplace transform of the sine of omega t, we have used this property. So as per the Euler's identity, the sine omega t can be given as e to the power j omega t minus e to the power minus j omega t divided by 2j. That means the Laplace transform of the sine omega t is equivalent to the Laplace transform of this term. So as per the linearity property, the Laplace transform of this entire term is equivalent to the Laplace transform of this individual exponential terms. So here, this 1 divided by 2j is the constant. So we have seen that the Laplace transform of this e to the power j omega t is equal to 1 divided by s minus j omega. And likewise, the Laplace transform of this e to the power minus j omega t is equal to 1 divided by s plus j omega. So further, if we do the algebraic manipulation, then we will get this omega divided by s square plus omega square. So that is the linearity property of the Laplace transform. So similarly, now let us see the scaling property. So if the Laplace transform of the function x of t is equal to x of s, then as per this property, the Laplace transform of the x of a t is equal to 1 divided by a times x of s divided by a, where this a is some constant and a is greater than 0. So let us see the proof of this property. So as per the definition of the Laplace transform, the Laplace transform of the x of a t is equal to integration of 0 minus to infinity x of a t times e to the power minus st times dt. So here, let's say the z is equal to a t. So if we differentiate this term, then this dz is equal to a times dt. That means now, in this expression, this dt is equal to dz divided by a. And now, we can replace this a t with the z. And here, the integration limits will remain the same. Because whenever this t is equal to 0, then this z is also 0. And whenever this t is equal to infinite, then this z is also equal to infinite. That means the new limits will also remain the same. So now, we will have this 1 divided by a times integration 0 minus to infinity x of z times e to the power minus s times z divided by a times dz. That means in the exponential term, here we have replaced the t with the z divided by a. So now, with the little rearrangement in the exponential term, it can be written as e to the power minus s divided by a times z. So we know that in the Laplace transform, the integration of this x of t times e to the power minus st is equal to x of s. So here, instead of the variable t, we have the variable z. And here, instead of the s, we have a s divided by a in the exponential term. That means this integration is equivalent to the x of s divided by a. So we can say that the Laplace transform of this x of a t is equal to 1 divided by a times x of s divided by a. So that is the scaling property of the Laplace transform. So similarly, now let us see the time shifting property of the Laplace transform. So as per this property, if the Laplace transform of some function x of t is equal to x of s, then the Laplace transform of the function x of t minus a is equal to e to the power minus as times x of s. So here, this u of t indicates that this function exists only for the t greater than or equal to 0. So similarly, When this function is time shifted, then this u of t minus a indicates that this function exists only for the t greater than or equal to a. And here, this a is greater than or equal to 0. So now, let us see the proof of this property. So as per the definition of the Laplace transform, the Laplace transform of this function is equal to integration 0 minus to infinity, this function times e to the power minus st times dt. Now here, this u of t minus a is the time shifted unit step function. That means it is equal to 1 whenever the t is greater than or equal to a. And the value of this function is 0 for the t less than a. So here, since the function does not exist for the t less than a, so we can change the integration limits from a to infinity. So now, let's say this z is equal to t minus a. So if we differentiate this term, then this dz is equal to dt. Moreover, now let us also see the new integration limits. So whenever this t is equal to a, then this z is equal to 0. And likewise, when the t is equal to infinity, then this z is also equal to infinity. That means now, our new integration limits will be from 0 to infinity. And now, this expression can be written as x of z times e to the power minus s times z plus a times dz. So basically, we have replaced the t minus a with the z. And in the exponential term, this t is equivalent to z plus a. So further, we can write this exponential term as e to the power minus sz times e to the power minus as. So here, we can take this e to the power minus as terms outside. And now, this term is equivalent to the Laplace transform of the function x of s. Because here, instead of the variable t, we have the variable z. That means this integration is equivalent to the x of s. That means the Laplace transform of the x of t minus a is equal to e to the power minus as times x of s. So for example, we have seen that the Laplace transform of the sine omega t u of t is equal to omega divided by s square plus omega square. So using the time shifting property, we can easily find the Laplace transform of sine of omega times t minus a. And that is equal to e to the power minus as times omega divided by s square plus omega square. So that is the time shifting property of the Laplace transform. So similarly, now let us see the frequency shifting property. So if the Laplace transform of the function x of t is equal to x of s, then as per this frequency shifting property, the Laplace transform of the function e to the power minus at times x of t is equal to x of s plus a. That means whenever some function x of t gets multiplied with the exponential function e to the power minus at, then in the Laplace transform, the s will get replaced by the s plus a. And it is very easy to prove it. So as per the definition of the Laplace transform of e to the power minus at times x of t is equal to integration 0 minus to infinity, this function times e to the power minus st times dt. And like I said earlier, here this u of t just indicates that this function exists only for the t greater than or equal to 0. So now, combining these exponential terms, we can write it as this x of t times e to the power minus s plus a times t. That means now, in the exponential term, instead of the variable s, we have s plus a. And therefore, it represents the x of s plus a. That means the Laplace transform of the function e to the power minus at times x of t is equal to x of s plus a. So in the previous video also, we have used this frequency shifting property. For example, we know that the Laplace transform of the function cos omega t times u of t is equal to s divided by s square plus omega square. So when this function gets multiplied with the e to the power minus at, then in the Laplace transform, the s will get replaced by the s plus a. That means the Laplace transform of the function e to the power minus at times cos omega t is equal to s plus a divided by s plus a square plus omega square. So in this way, when we see any exponential term in the function, then we can use this frequency shifting property of this Laplace transform. So in this video, we have seen the four properties of the Laplace transform. So in the next video, we will see the remaining properties. So if you have any question or suggestion, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.